artificial intelligence. Maybe you've heard of it? Good, good start. Well, we've got some options on what to talk about, and actually, I'd like to take a vote. Raise your hand if you'd like to talk about the benefits of AI. Okay, and raise your hand if you want to talk about the risks. Fascinating. I mean, absolutely pointless because I've made the slides already, but still, really interesting. Now, as an optimist, what I'd like to talk about today and explore with you is, will AI kill us all? And what is AI anyway? It's complicated, it's hard to even know because it means so many different things. However, when people say AI today, in this crazy world, they usually mean neural networks, deep learning, which is just big neural networks, and large language models, which is big neural networks applied to autocomplete, so predicting the next word in a sentence. So how does AI autocomplete work? Well, we got a prediction calculator, and we put in a phrase, and we just ask the machine to guess what word should come next. Now, I want you to think about the prediction calculator as this machine, tons of dials that just relate to some unknown settings. Okay, and what we're going to do, we're going to put a phrase in like the sky is, and the machine is going to guess. It's a bad guess at the start because it just starts off random. But it will tweak those dials through trial and error, and it will try and find the right settings to predict the sky is blue. Now, if we know the answer, we can train it like this, but we can also just feed back on the output, and the machine will learn the right settings by tweaking those dials, and it will learn our preferences. So we can now just train on more data. Let's say, for example, the whole of the internet. And although it will make some mistakes, and it will make some stupid mistakes at times, it will be, on average, correct over all of those examples most of the time in predicting what should come next. Now, this is really powerful because you can predict the next words a helpful assistant might say, or even the next words in a complex plan. However, the power really comes because language is magical. The written word is a proxy for a thought process. You think, and then you write. So it's almost like these machines have been trained to predict the next step in a thought process. Although there is no thought process, it's just trained on the proxy. They are streams of unconsciousness. So blathering out word after word with not a conscious thought in sight. So where is the limit for this AI? Well, whether you call it superintelligence, artificial general intelligence, or AGI, the aim is to create machines that are better than humans at every cognitive task. And AI labs think they can take that autocomplete machine and scale it up to be superintelligence. That's a little bit like saying you'd take this kid's volcano experiment and scale it up to Mount Vesuvius. There's a big difference between ChatGPT and our human brains. But the bitter lesson of AI so far is if you make a bigger machine with more dials and more data, it will figure out more things and you will get more intelligence. So can it scale to superintelligence? The truth is, we don't know. We've never dealt with this type of scale before, and it's only getting bigger. There's more data than ever before, more compute power than ever before, and that data and compute power are cheaper, more accessible, and more specialized at tweaking those dials than ever before. So if scale is all we need, then we're on the right path. So let's assume superintelligence is possible. What could we see along the way? Well, today, we don't have to take any meeting minutes anymore. Not that inspirational, but still, good progress. Tomorrow, you might have real-time personalized media, where you could say, make me a new James Bond film starring me, set it in Birmingham, and make my brother the bad guy. You might be able to have a doctor in your pocket that knows everything about you and is focused 24/7 on your health and well-being, bringing in your family medical history and every medicine that's ever been researched. All diseases might be cured. There may be no work, just play. We might have world peace, space exploration, bringing consciousness to every corner of the universe. The future could be golden. But what are the risks? Well, we're living through them now. Our reality is distorted. Digital verification is dead. You cannot trust any video, audio, image, or text online. Even if you were watching this talk, you couldn't be sure if it had really happened or if it was AI generated. And it's also impossible not to humanize AI. People will project their thoughts, feelings, and consciousness onto their chatbots, and they will fall in love. And they already are. But what about our kids? I was on holiday last week and looking over the hotel restaurant. Every single table had kids of any age glued to iPads and screens. Now, I'm not judging as a parent. I know it's hard and you need a break sometimes, but it's become a habit and it's the modern day pacifier. So nobody feels good about their kids zombied out in front of a screen. Would you feel better if they were engaging with AI? You could ask ChatGPT today to watch your kids eat dinner and tell them a story about superheroes, embed the value of kindness, weave in some teaching about photosynthesis, but only tell them the next line of the story when they eat a bite of dinner. What does it mean when AI is going to be raising a generation of kids? Because it will. We used to live in tribes, and you had to get on with your neighbor and negotiate your views with theirs, or you would be outcast. And then we went to towns and cities. And across millions of people in the city, you could find someone that aligned with your worldview and shared some interests. And then we went to the internet. You had almost unlimited chance to find forums full of people who would agree with anything at all. And then we had social media. Now, the algorithm was meant to predict what we want to see next and show it to us. But instead, in order to meet that objective, it made us more predictable. So it drove us to the extremes and it rewired our brains. Because if you hold a more extreme position and you're addicted to scrolling, it's much easier to predict what you'd like to click on next. And now we have AI. And you can have every event, past, present, and future, told to you through your own custom narrative. You never have to negotiate with anyone at all. So we will live in separate realities. What does that mean for trust? Because trust is vital to a human society. If you didn't trust anyone, you couldn't walk down the street because you'd think every car might swerve into you. So we need to trust each other, but we cannot trust AI or what it outputs. It's not human. It doesn't think, it doesn't feel, it doesn't know. It just pattern matches to predict something plausible. Plausible is not true. So in order to get more performance out of AI, we need to give it more data. And as you open up more of your life to AI, you are going to be more exposed to cybercrime. And at the same time, it's never been easier to be a cybercriminal. You can ask AI to generate you the code to hack into anything at all, from your local zoo to a national bank. No one is safe when you can launch a cyber attack on a whim. It won't just be nation states or hardened cyber criminals. It will be people bored and just curious to see what will happen. And we're seeing that play out now. But that's humans misusing AI. What about the dangers from AI itself? Well, if we can't control super intelligent AI, it will probably end up, one way or another, killing us all. Imagine we have a machine and we give it a really mundane, simple task. We want you to make as many paperclips as possible. Well, it can't make paperclips if it's turned off, and humans can turn it off, so it kills all humans. Or maybe to stop its circuits rusting, it extracts all the oxygen out of the atmosphere and kills all humans. Or to have enough materials for paperclips, it starts breaking down everything on Earth into atoms and kills all humans. There are infinite possible ways a super intelligent machine could meet an objective we give it. We have no chance of thinking about all the different side effects. And we see this play out with social media. Nobody's happy about how that turned out, but the machine is fulfilling its objective. So, we've experienced that already. In a complex universe, the law of unintended consequences wins. But we will want super intelligent AI to solve problems for us. That's what it's for. So maybe the solution is to keep a human in the loop. Take self-driving cars. There's a fail-safe where if the machine gets confused, it can just hand back control to the human. But after a couple of incident-free trips, that human is going to be asleep or reading a book or just disengaged and not able to take control in an emergency. That will cause catastrophic accidents, but that's not AI's fault. That's on us. And it's not just driving, teaching, programming, just work in general. Our attention, skills, and motivation will waste away as we accept the convenience AI brings. People will hand over power to these machines prematurely, and the human in the loop will be removed, because cutting them out means you can move 10,000 times faster. And that is an advantage you cannot give up in a race. And we are in a race to AGI. It's winner take all. There's no prize for second place, and everyone wants to control superintelligence. If we don't make it first, someone else will. Whoever is first can immediately shut down all other efforts, because if you have superintelligence, you can figure out and control anything. That's why on one hand, you have AI companies saying, regulate us, please, we're dealing with really powerful stuff. And on the other hand, they say, but if you regulate us, other people won't get regulated, then they win, we lose, game over. It's a war for AI, and in wartime, regulations dissolve. But the AI labs say that superintelligence is imminent. Can they control it? Relax, they say. We'll figure it out when we get there. Or we could even just use AI to control AI. If we've got superintelligent AI, it can outthink less intelligent AI, us, and everything else. The single best strategy that we have for superintelligent AI to be aligned to humans is hope. Just a hope that somehow it will be aligned. Or maybe it's not a problem anyway. Of course we'll be able to control superintelligence, and all we need is to know exactly what we want, be able to articulate it really clearly, and to have the whole world agree. We're doomed. AI is being led by entrepreneurs and software developers who come from the school of move fast and break things. They have blind faith it will be okay, with their heads down, iterating towards who knows where, and closing their eyes to the dangers from superintelligence. We need a different approach. But at the same time, wallowing in cynical doom and gloom is resigning to defeat. The benefits of AI are vast, and while it's not going anywhere, there's nothing inevitable about how this plays out. We want to aim for the good, but balance that with the risks and guard against them. A return to philosophy. Think of the big ideas, explore different perspectives, and truly wrestle with the issues up front. AI has the potential to make our lives infinitely better, to make us more human, not a lesser being, but we must chase AI alignment with humanity with the same vigor that we chase superintelligence, if not more. There's no box we can put superintelligence back into. The genie will be out of the bottle. There's no second tries, no do-overs. Once it's here, it's too late. Like when you voted at the start of this talk which direction you wanted to take, but you had no influence because the slides were made. You do not want to have an opinion on the future and have it mean nothing because the story has already been written for you. Alignment has to be a core goal. It cannot be an afterthought. It's the courageous path, the honest path that says, look, AI might be rubbish today, but if we think there's a chance that it scales to superintelligence, let's aim for the world we want to live in and mitigate the risks along the way, rather than blindly racing humanity off the edge of a cliff.